I'm so excited to present our invited speaker to the stage. Helen Nash is enrolled in Highlands Achieve Program. She's a passionate social justice advocate with Down syndrome. She graduated from Nathan Hill High School, where she participated in swim team and Pride Club and Unified Drama. Helen is also an active on the Seahawks racing team, Special Olympics, Unified Sporting Teams as well. So we're so excited to have you here today. Please give a warm welcome to Helen Nash.
Thank you, Garrick. All right, let's begin. It all started when I was a little girl. When I was born, no one in my family knew I had a disability, including myself. When I was in elementary school, I knew I had an extra chromosome, but I didn't know I had a disability. I felt included socially and academically. I loved the teachers there, and they gave me the attention and the things I needed from them. As the years went on, middle school came around. The school district wanted to put me in a contained classroom, but my parents fought against it and placed me into the mainstream school community there. By the time I was in 7th and 8th grade, I felt mostly included. Most of the friends that I made happened then. I liked the teachers even more. They were really nice and helpful. They knew what it was I needed, and whenever I needed the help, they were there to help me. I made more friends when I was there. Most of them did not have a disability like me. Some of them did. Finally, when high school came around, I went to Nathan Hill. I felt comfortable with the place, and I felt included into their system. From there, I loved the teachers, and they gave me the attention I needed, and to make sure that I was successful. During junior year, I had a senior friend, Nate, spoke out at a MLK Day assembly about the LGBTQ rights and how LGBTQ students were being segregated and discriminated against. This was heartbreaking and very inspirational to me. With his inspiration, I wrote a speech myself on an issue that I really cared about, but this happened later. During the last 2 weeks or so of the summer of my junior year, I met another person who opened me up to an issue that I had not looked at seriously before. Disability inclusion. I did a 2-week summer camp with an organization called Outdoors for All, a familiar organization that you all might know. It worked out all too well since my first week overlapped with that of a friend of mine. His name, Liam Neville. And he too had a disability. And on the 26th of August, he asked me out on a date, and I accepted it with Liam as my boyfriend. Everything I knew about myself had changed. He was in a contained classroom at the same school as me. But 3 years of high school, I had never seen him or met him. Liam introduced to me another community friend who I didn't get to know at all. People in the contained classrooms who were funny, fun to be around, and full of high energy. I found a whole new community of friends who also happened to have disabilities. However, though, I also noted that Liam's class was isolated from the rest of the school. They ate lunch together, alone, and no one else sat at their table. Well, except me. Some days, they ate in their classroom because they had a different schedule than the rest of us. I often joined Liam there, but some days the teacher didn't allow me to go in. The more I thought about it, about how separated I was from Liam and the other friends, even though we attended the same school, the more anger I felt. Remembering Nate's example, I saw how both the LGBTQ community connected with a disability community, and that they were experiencing the same issues. I wanted to make the point that we had a school inside a school at Nathan Hale. I made my senior project on disability inclusion. I gave my own speech when the next MLK assembly came around. Sharing with the community about the history of segregating people with disabilities. There are lots of great examples of inclusion at Nathan Hale. We had unified drama and unified soccer. Being unified is when people with and without disabilities get together to produce or have fun with an activity they all like. This was the best way to make new friends. I now go to school here at Highline College. This college is a truly inclusive community. It welcomes people with disabilities, immigrants, LGBTQ students, people of color, and everyone else. I am sharing this with you all today because I want to make the world more like Highline. Without you, we will not get our voices heard. If you know the work of Dr. Seuss, it is like we are the who's in Whoville. And while we are speaking up for ourselves, we need more Hortons to speak for us and with us. We want people like you to lobby schools for more inclusion. Help create more unified activities in the community and make wise choices when you vote. Fight for us. Help us fly. There's one other thing I would like to share before I give the mic over. My speech that I just read off to you is actually a call. A call for people like you to join Unified Club, the leadership club, happening today at 1:15 to 2:15 in Building 99. I hope you guys can come. Thank you.
One more big round of applause for Helen Ash. Thank you.